Hello, Hilton Baptist. I don't know about you, but as a parent, a teacher, a coach, I feel that I've spent a lot of my life repeating myself. Now, it might be because I've given poor instructions. It could be my hearer wasn't really paying attention. But I'd like to think I repeated myself so much because it was important. That the information, the skill set, the knowledge I was trying to convey was important for the hearer's next step in their life, in order for them to be successful in what came next. This idea of repetition is important for us in studying scripture. Sometimes an author, in trying to make his point, repeats himself time and time again. We see this here in James 2, 14 through 26. Look at verse 14. James says, "What good is it if you have faith apart from works?" Verse 16, after giving an example of faith apart from works, he says, "What good is it?" Verse 17, "Faith by itself without works is dead." Verse 20, "Faith apart from works is dead." Verse 26, "Faith apart from works is dead." James is trying to make a point here. He's repeating himself, and he's trying to get us, his hearers, to understand that if we have a faith that doesn't produce works, then it's dead, then it's useless. Remember earlier in the passage, he asks, can this faith save him? Is this a saving faith? And James is telling us, no, this is not a saving faith. Well, I'm pretty sure that we all want a saving faith. So that means we need a faith that's alive. Well, how do we know something's alive? Well, one of the key definitions of life is that it reproduces. Like reproduces like. Reproduction is a sign of life. Well, what should we be producing? What should we be reproducing if we have a living faith? Well, James gives us a bit of a clue in 20, and it will spark a thought in us. In verse 20, the King James version of verse 20 says that faith apart from works is dead. But the word that the King James translates as dead is a different word than the words that we see in verse 17 and in verse 26. The translation in verse 20 that King James says is dead comes from a root word that means work. So it's really kind of workless. So most modern translations translate that as useless, that a faith apart from works is useless. Now that word was often used in an agrarian sense, and I deal with farming. So it really has this idea of fruitless, that a faith that doesn't produce fruit is a useless faith. It's not a saving faith. Well, I don't want to be in that boat. So how do I have a faith that produces fruit, that is fruitful? Well, it made me think about John 15. Listen to Jesus' words in John 15, verse 1. "I am the true vine, my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. Every branch that does not bear fruit, he prunes that it may bear more fruit. Already you are clean because of the word that I have spoken to you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself, unless it abides in the vine, neither can you, unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever abides in me, and I in him, he it is that bears much fruit, for apart from me, you can do nothing." We see repetition used here again by Jesus, and he's trying to drive home a point that if we want to be fruitful Christians, if we want to show evidence of a saving faith, if we want to have the works that go with our faith, then our faith is born out of abiding in him. We have to abide in him to produce fruit. Now, often when we hear the word abide, we think it's a passive, but it's not. It's active. It's actually being involved with God. Well, how are we involved with him? Well, one, we read scripture. This is how God has revealed himself. We need to know his word if we're going to know him. Two, we're to spend time in prayer. We are to commune with God. We are to communicate with him. He is to communicate with us. We are to spend time in prayer. Lastly, I think we need to be involved in a fellowship of believers, like-minded Christians that are seeking to produce fruit, that are seeking to have a faith that saves, because a faith that saves is a faith that produces works. Those works are the fruit of our lives, the reproduction, like producing like. As God works in our lives to make us Christ-like, the work we produce produces that same thing in other people in the world around us. So a saving faith is a faith that abides in Jesus. It's not my works that make me righteous. It's not my works that make me, that save me. It's not my works that justify me before God. It's the fact that I abide in Christ. I am part of him. We are together. He is the vine. I am the branches. I pray that today you will abide in Jesus. Allow him to have his full and complete work in you. And by abiding in him, we would produce much fruit to the glory of God.